Today we're talking about computing courses. Hey everybody, welcome back. I hope life is treating you well. Today I want to talk about courses. Also, I have some news about a new course that I just released, but more about that at the end of the video because I know you clicked on this video because you want to talk about courses. Specifically, it's one of the questions that comes up a lot with students is they often, whether they're just curious or whether they're annoyed by a particular class, they're often saying things like, am I ever going to use this class again? Is this class important? Is this class important? How important is this? Do I really need to take this? Jacob, what are your top two or three courses that you think are most important? Things like that. Now, of course, this is a topic where I expect there to be a lot of opinions, maybe strong opinions. This is just my opinion, and it's very possible that I might forget something really important. And of course, next week I might change my mind. So take a deep breath, relax, remember that we're all friends. And while you're taking a deep breath and relaxing, go down to the comments section and let me know what your top two picks for like most important programming, computer science, computer engineering courses are, what you think are like the critical two that everyone should take. Okay, so now that you're calm, now that you've commented and we're ready to go, let's get into it. Now, during my time in academia, I have noticed that this problem, this question of courses, which ones are more important than others, which ones are essential and which ones are optional, this is becoming a bigger and bigger challenge, both for universities and for students. One reason for this is there are a lot of courses that just didn't exist when I was an undergrad. When I was an undergrad, I couldn't take machine learning or mobile app development or embedded systems. And embedded systems is what I do every day. Back then, I didn't even know what an embedded system was. But as the field grows and we keep getting more and more subfields and different angles, different technologies that we could teach you, students are going around wondering what's most important, and universities are trying to adjust their curriculum to account for this growth. And so, of course, universities everywhere get all their faculty members together and they have these meetings where they discuss which classes should be required, which one should be the core of the program, and which one should be optional. And of course, everybody loves their topic, they love the classes they teach, and pretty soon all the classes are on the required list. But of course, the university also wants their students to graduate sometime, so we have to start trimming. So today I just wanted to take a moment to talk about courses, the ones that I think are most critical, both for you to not just take, but really master, like the ones that are really going to make a big difference in your career. Now, first, a few caveats. Everything I'm about to say depends very much on what you want to do with your life. If your life's ambition is to make mobile apps, then the classes that are most important for you are definitely going to be different from the student who wants nothing more than to make high-performance web servers for the rest of their life. And of course, I'm going to give this advice as if I had no idea what you want to do with your life, because frankly, between you and me, I don't. I'm also assuming that you want to be a very good, very capable software developer. If, on the other hand, you're just trying to pick up a few skills so you can get a quick job editing HTML pages, well, then this advice might not be a good fit for you. That's okay. I'm not here to judge. We all have different goals. The other caveat is I'm talking about topics here. This all depends very much on how the topic is taught. You can take the same course and teach it in one way where it's wonderfully valuable and teach it in another where, not so much. Okay, so enough of the caveats. Let's get into my list. Okay, we're going to start with my top three. These are actually in no particular order. But let's start off with data structures and algorithms. Absolutely essential. Some schools teach these as two classes, some combine them into one, but learning how to solve problems systematically and learning how to manage data, how to store data in different ways so that you can access it efficiently is absolutely essential. A big part of your computer science or computer engineering education is rewiring your brain, teaching yourself how to think systematically, teaching yourself how to take a simple set of instructions that a computer gives you and solve complicated problems. And I don't know of any topic that does that so well as data structures and algorithms. So number two on my list is operating systems or computer systems. Sometimes it's one class, sometimes they're called different things, sometimes it's two or three classes. And I know at this point, a lot of you are saying, hey, wait a minute, don't you teach operating systems? And I do, it's true, and I love it, but just because I'm biased doesn't make me wrong. So if taught well, and that's a big if, your operating systems class or computer systems, we'll just call them your systems classes, are going to teach you how the world works underneath your program. They're going to teach you how to manage shared resources. They're going to teach you how to handle things concurrently. They're going to teach you how memory works, and that's a really big one. And hopefully, if it's taught the way I like to teach it, there's a lot of low-level hands-on programming experience as well. Now, number three. Now, in this one, I'm not even sure what to call it because it's called so many different things at so many different universities, but every program seems to have at least one class that teaches object-oriented programming and principles of software design. Now, I know a lot of you think of me as the C guy. I'm probably going to take some flack for this, but it's true. A lot of modern software is object-oriented or has pieces that are object-oriented, and you're going to have a hard time being competitive in this world if you don't understand the basics of classes and objects. And I know so far on this channel, I haven't talked a lot about things like inheritance and polymorphism, but that doesn't mean that they aren't really important. Because trust me, you don't want to be the coder who shows up and can't do half the projects because you have a strict no objects policy. Not understanding object-oriented programming is just unnecessarily limited. Okay, so those are my top three, and really I stopped at three because, well, I gave myself a limit and I said I was gonna come up with the top three, but let's talk about some honorable mentions. Now I can almost hear the cries of protest, the fact that I didn't include networking in my top three. And of course, networking topics are often included in your systems classes, so maybe we could just kind of squish it into number two right there. And maybe I should have done that in the first place, but yeah, either way, understanding the internet is really critical. And because so many systems today are distributed or have distributed components, it's going to be, again, really limiting if you don't understand how networks work and you don't know how to make your code interact with them. Next, I want to include the classes that I'll call them your depth classes. These are the really under the hood, low level classes like computer architecture and your assembly language course. I have discussed assembly language in a previous video and how I feel about it, so I'm not going to rehash that whole thing. But I do think it's really valuable to take classes that help you understand how low-level hardware, how your processor actually works. These classes can help you understand why some things are faster than others, why some things are more energy efficient than others, and also just why some things work the way they do. And also, now that I'm thinking about it, I can probably add compilers and programming languages to this group as well. These classes are gonna change the way you think. I think they're gonna make you a much better programmer, but you can get by without them. You can have a good programming career and have never understood how the internals of a compiler work. You can be a solid programmer and not understand how pipelined architecture work. Come to think of it, I don't know when the last time I actually needed to remember the details of Thomas Hulot's algorithm, but I'm still glad I learned it. And actually, throughout my career, I've been surprised at how many times my compiler classes have come in very handy in different projects that I've worked on. Next, I can hear some of you saying, you haven't mentioned math at all. So I'm going to throw in discrete math or discrete structures, as it's sometimes called. And this is just, I won't go into details, but this is just really valuable because up until this point in your life, most of the math that you've studied has been continuous. You know, calculus, algebra, all continuous. But computer science, computers in general, tend to be very discrete things, and so discrete math comes in enormously handy. Next on my list, I'm going to add a web development or user interfaces course. Even if your life goal is to write terminal apps or to write kernel level internal stuff, I really can't emphasize too much how many things are on the web and how many things end up at some point needing a user interface. No matter what you do, sooner or later, someone's going to ask you to put this code you wrote on the web, or they're going to ask you to get it to interact with some web app. And of course, understanding how event loops and model view controller architectures and windowing systems, understanding how all this user interface stuff works it's just super helpful. It's hard to imagine you could write your own operating system without understanding a lot about user interfaces. Okay, up next. Now, I know my list is getting kind of long here, but I've got to throw in security. Security really matters. There was a time, a long time ago, when we didn't pay much attention to security, but the stakes keep going up. The consequences of insecure code keep going up. We keep reading about it in the news all the time. And I'm just telling you, you don't want to be the reason that a hospital can't provide service or that the southeastern United States can't get gas for their cars. Taking a security class, preferably one that covers software security and network security, is going to raise your level of awareness. You're going to see things that you didn't see before. It's not going to make you perfect by any stretch, but it's definitely going to help you write better code that's more secure. Another class that I'm going to throw in here that definitely wouldn't have made my list a decade ago is machine learning. I used to always think of machine learning and AI as sort of this side piece of computer science, but ML is finding its way into just about everything. It's hard to find a system or an area of computing where someone isn't applying machine learning to it. Now, I'm not saying you need to become the world's expert on ML, but I do think you want to learn enough about it so that you're not afraid of it. You're not intimidated by it, and you can use it when it makes sense. Now, I want to point out one thing that's kind of interesting about all these courses, and that is that courses at the university level tend to be organized around a particular technical topic. And one thing that I don't think schools teach generally very well is the strategy for how to do well in all those classes, how to learn to program well, how to rewire your brain, how to master this material, basically how to succeed in your computing education. Because I see it all the time. Students show up to classes and they make a lot of mistakes. We all make a lot of mistakes. And a lot of the strategies for how to get good at this stuff really quickly just aren't taught. Your instructors may assume you already know them, or they may imply them or hint at them. But I think a lot of instructors out there assume that their students know what they're doing, or hope that Either they know what they're doing and often they don't. So if this feels like you, if you're in a program or you're trying to get into a program, whatever, if you're trying to learn this stuff and you're struggling, you're feeling frustrated, if this feels like you, then I just wanted to let you know about a course that I just released that focuses on these strategy issues. Rather than focus on specific technical topics, this course is all about strategy and how to approach these topics so that you master the material and become more competent and more confident quickly. Because let's face it, it's no fun to be sitting there looking at the people around you feeling like they are racing ahead and leaving you behind and not understanding why you might not be getting the same results that they are. Some parts of the course are still under construction, so I decided to make the course available prematurely and also at half price while I finish things up. It's available on Thinkific. I'll put a link down in the description. Please check it out if you think it might help you get back on track. So I hope this video helps you all. If you haven't yet, make sure to let me know down below in the comments what your top two or three courses are. Like this video if it was helpful, subscribe so you don't miss the next one. And until the next video, I'll see you later.